yoga friends, and welcome back to my 30-day yoga challenge, where we do 10 minutes of yoga a day for 30 days. My name is Jessica, and this is day 18. We'll be doing a yin sequence all about improving and helping our digestive system today, beginning in child's pose. We will also need some sort of yoga block or block-like prop, maybe a thick book or a Tupperware. You can even use like a super thick pillow. So just have that ready by your mat. Starting in child's pose here, feet together, maybe knees wide today, coming down onto the mat. If placing your forehead on the mat is not comfortable, you can always place your forehead on the block. And bring your arms out straight or maybe slightly bent here. Fluttering the eyes closed, or taking a soft gaze, evening out the breath in and out through the nose. Let's begin our practice by setting an intention. The one I'll be using today is going to be a great day. Today is going to be a great day. And begin to inhale that intention through your nose, deep into your belly, and open the mouth, sigh, exhale out anything extra that you may have brought onto your mat today, knowing that you can always return to your intention throughout your practice and perhaps throughout the rest of your day. We're gonna stay in our child's pose here. Evening that breath. Scanning the body for any tension we can let go of. Maybe noticing how the lower belly and back expand and contract naturally. Not forcing anything there, but just noticing. Let's take three more rounds of breath here. And on your next inhale, if your arms aren't straight out in front of you, go ahead and straighten them and simply place your left hand on top of the right, stretching out the left side body. Next inhale, bring those arms back to center and place the right hand on the left, stretching out through the right side body. And next inhale, bring everything back to that child's pose. Let's take one more round of breath here. And on our next inhale, gently roll up to find a seat on your bum, legs straight out in front of you, setting up for caterpillar. Let's flex both feet here, sitting up nice and tall. Inhale, arms to the ceiling. Exhale, fold over those legs. Maybe resting the palms on the calves or the shins.
around the balls of the feet or the heels, wherever you start to feel sensation here. Feel free to also get your block involved by maybe resting your forehead on your block. Or just allow your head, neck, and shoulders to relax in the air. These forward folds will allow new circulation of our blood to come rushing back into our digestive system here, the stomach, the intestines, that whole area once we come out of this pose. Feel free here to get a little bit deeper into the pose on your exhales, if your body wants to do that today. Let's take three more rounds of breath here. And on your next inhale, gently roll up one vertebrae at a time back to that seated position. Let's go ahead and windshield wiper the feet from side to side here, just a little bit. Before bending our knees, bring your soles of the feet to the ground, hands behind us. We're going to cross the right ankle over the left thigh for a seated figure four. Getting this nice hip opener here, just as a transition to our next yin posture, making sure that right foot is flexed to protect the knee. Two more rounds of breath on this side. And next exhale. Gently uncross that right leg, and let's cross that left ankle over the right thigh, making sure that left foot is flexed. And two more rounds of breath here. And next exhale, gently uncross that left leg. Let's find our way down to our backs, bringing our block with us. We're gonna set up for our last yin posture, supported bridge pose. So making sure our legs are hip width distance apart. Let's inhale, press the feet, lift the pelvis just enough to slide our block underneath. I like using the low setting here. Bringing our hands, palms up, down by our sides. releasing here, letting go. If you do want to go a little deeper into this pose, feel free to straighten the legs here. If that pinches your lower back, come back to the supported bridge. We'll take three more rounds of breath here. Let's gently press through our feet, lifting our pelvis just enough to slide that block from underneath us. Inhaling both knees into chest, giving ourselves a nice little hug, maybe rocking side to side before releasing down in our shavasana for the day. Adjusting any clothing or hair that might be distracting. Scanning the body for any tension that we can exhale. And simply letting go here in our final resting pose. You are welcome to stay in your shavasana for as long as you'd like, as this is where I'm going to leave you. I want to thank you for coming to practice with me today, and I look forward to seeing you tomorrow for day 19. Namaste.